दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्रीचिद्घनगणेशानुमोमय्यं सुखं नित्यं स्वप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धेर्लोक्यत्वेन अपारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महः तदेव अहन्नमत्तोऽन्यत्ति मे निश्चिता मतिः। Okay, so we began with the fifth chapter before the long break. So just to cover up the mistakes, there was one shloka I had did a wrong padachheda. So there avatirya, although the explanation was right, avatirya, but while saying I was saying avatirya instead of avatirya. So it's a lebanta pada. And since there is anvaya across shlokas, what I said is Shankaracharya Rupena Shivaha Sakshat Avatirya, taking avatara as Shankaracharya in the form of Shankaracharya, Sakshat Shiva himself, Anyata Bhutam. So not Yatha Bhutam, but Anyata Bhutam. This Anyata Anyata Varnyate Vedartha Kalau Yuge in Kali Yuga by many of the philosophers, darshanas, even the new religions, anyatha anyatha. The idea of the Vedas may be there. Without their knowing that the source is Vedas, still others may also have begun there without knowing and lost their way, thereby anyatha anyatha, varnyate. And to set that right, Shankaracharya Rupena Shivaha Sakshat Avatirya Anyata Bhutam Jaina Baudhadikam Matam. All these Jaina and Baudh Adipadena, everything else can be included, which is not Advaita really. Nirmulayishyati Akhilam. Completely, it is said that he is going to, since this is in the Puranas, it is mentioned. Sorry. It's a little akara. So Shankaracharya is going to take avatara. Shiva is going to take avatara in the form of Shankaracharya, and thereby he is going to uproot all the misunderstandings by Vedavakyas, using Vedavakyas along with the Yuktis. So that is the right interpretation there with Padachheda. Then we were yet to begin with 228th avarta. This is Advaitam Eva Pramanikam Iti Valmikehe Api Abhiprayaha. Even Valmiki Maharshi says that in Ramayana, in some version of Ramayana or some part of Ramayana rather, Ramayana in the sense, the teaching given to Rama. So it is during the time of Rama and as taught to Rama. Advaitam eva pramanikam. Thereby, Shri Valmiki Radhi Virad Akhilartha Darshi Maharshi Uttara Ramayane. So Uttara Ramayana, some do not consider in Ramayana. So in Uttara Ramayana, it is said, Vasishtakhya Grante, which is also the teaching given by Vasishta Muni to Bhagavan Rama. So in that Grantha, Sarvopanishad Sutra Bhuta Mandukyartha Avishkarana Pradhane, Shri Rama Vasishta Samvada Rupena Abhivyakta Vartikatmake Upakramadi Shadvidha Tatparya Lingaihi Drishtanta Sahasraihi Itihasa Shataischa Advaitam eva pramanam iti nirupayati. So there, who nirupayati? Shri Valmiki. So Bhagavan Valmiki in the Uttara Ramayana has said that Advaita is pramana. Eva, Advaitam eva pramanam. Elaborately it has been discussed in the form of samvada between Sri Rama and Vasishtha Muni. And what is the content there? Advaita, but still which prakriya? There he says, Sarvopanishad Sutra Bhuta Mandukyartha Avishkarana Pradhani. Which is committed to, primarily to, explain the teachings of Mandukya Upanishad, which is Sutra Bhuta. Mandukya Upanishad is the shortest Upanishad. It has only 12 mantras, but it is immensely complex for those who do not have a background. It is committed to Drishti Srishti Vada, uses Ajata Vada, and committed to Drishti Srishti Vada. It's a shortcut method to moksha if properly understood. Otherwise, one can remain confused and become a Neo-Vedantin even. So that Mandukya Upanishad, which is the essence of entire Vedas or Veda Vedanta, that is elaborately discussed in the Uttara Ramayana as a dialogue between Sri Rama and Vasishtha Muni, which is, you know, Abhivyakta Vartikatmake, which can also be called as a Vartika on the Upanishads. Upakramadi Shadvidha Tatpurya Lingaihi. Upakrama Upasamhara. Upakrama Upasamharo. There is Upakrama Upasamhara is one linga. There are six lingas. Abhyasa Apurvata Phalam. And then there is Arthavada and Upapatti. So Upakrama Upasamharo Abhyaso Purvata Phalam. These are the three. Upakrama and Upasamhara are the beginning and the end. Whatever is the Tatparya should be there in the beginning and the end. Generally, you know, if you are presenting something, you have a 1 or 2 hours of talk. Initially, we introduce the topic. Whatever is important is introduced. You may talk about a lot of things, but then still, Tatparya should be there in the introduction. It should attract the attention of people attending. They should know as to what is the main topic there. And in the ending, you summarize it. You don't summarize all the stories that you have brought up to bring out the moral of the story. The moral is discussed in the end. So, Upakrama and Upasamhara becomes a single linga, an indicator towards the tatparya of the grantha. So upakramadi shadvida tatparya lingaihi. Using those lingas there, so upakrama samhara abhyasa, whatever is important is repeated. There is abhyasa. Abhyasa is repetition. Then apurvata, something which cannot be known other than that grantha. Upanishad alone can reveal this Aikya, Advaitam, Tattva. Everything else can be known by other means. Advaita cannot be known through any other means except Upanishad. Therefore, that is the Tatparya. Apurvata. Apurvata means not found elsewhere. It was not there before Upanishads. And Upanishads themselves are beginningless. Therefore, Apurvata means that which is not present elsewhere. Upanishad is the only source. In whichever language, in whatever darshana, whichever philosophy, whatever religion, anyone talks about Aikya, if at all. There are people who reinterpret their own religions and their own philosophy to say that, oh, we also say the same thing that Vedanta says. It is not we also, it is only Vedanta. They have borrowed, begged, or stolen, they have stolen from the Veda Tatparya. Be it Bauddha Mata, or be it some Western philosophies, they have the source only in Vedas. One cannot stumble upon Aikya. Because it is your very nature. You cannot stumble upon yourself as an object. It has to be revealed. And it is revealed by Shastras. So that is a linga. Then phala. Phala has to be discussed. What is the result of knowing this aikya? Advaita tattva. Phala is sarva samsara nivritti, sarva dukkha nivritti and paramananda prapti. Nityatvena. That is the phala. Thereby, Advaita alone leads to that kind of phala. Therefore, Advaita is its atparya. Further, Arthavada. Arthavada is glorification. This glorification can be real or bordering on reality. Meaning, it can be exaggerated. There can be little truth, but then you glorify it with add-ons. Or it can be completely the truth. Glorification can be of any form. Yet another way of glorification is ninda, paraninda. Paraninda is another mata, purva paksha ninda, dvaita ninda. Dvaita khandana is done using nahi nindya, ninda nyaya. Nahi ninda nyaya says that you glorify the tatparya by doing ninda of the opposite. So dvaita ninda is done to glorify advaita. Therefore, advaita is the tatparya. That's also one way Upanishads themselves do ninda of dvaita, which will be covered later. So I'll not go into mantras. And final linga is upapatti, upapatti. So it's a dual in the end. Arthavado upapatti cha. So arthavadascha upapattischa arthavada upapatti. So both are separate lingas. Upapatti is tarka. Logic is used. And Shruti herself uses logic to express how to land on Advaita. Advaita is revealed by Shruti and you have to land on it by using tarka because the buddhi will present questions. Those have to be resolved. And how should they be resolved? You cannot keep on saying, no, have Shraddha in the Shastra. Shastra says so. Some people are not going to be convinced because buddhi is going to ask questions. That's why we have in the end, in the same grantha, Vichara Sagara, we have Tarka Drishti. Tarka Drishti is one who is going to use Tarka all the time. To that kind of a person also, the Shastra caters. Not Shushka Tarka, Tarka that is presented by the Shruti to reveal Advaita Tattva. How do I understand it? Is it possible to understand it? Yes. It is possible to understand it through logic also. Not through logic independently. Because for logic, pratyaksha is pramana. Pratyaksha is an input for tarka, anumana to work. That input cannot be there if it is just logic based on pratyaksha because atma is apratyaksha. Why apratyaksha? Because pratyakshatvam kim? Pratyakshatvam is objectification in Laukika. In Laukika, Pratyaksha does not have the meaning of Sakshatkara or Aparoksha Jnana. It has Pratyaksha Pramana deals with the Indriyas. So, Indriya Gocharatvam is expected whereas Atma is Indriya Gochara. Being Indriya Gochara, Pratyaksha cannot be objectifying Atma, which is Advaita Tattva, whereby Anumana does not get the input of Pratyaksha and therefore Anumana cannot work. Then how does Anumana still land on Advaita? By the Shruti Mulaka, Tarka. That Tarka which is presented by the Shruti, just like once you know Advaita is a possibility as revealed by the Shruti because there is no other source for Advaita, then Tarka can be used to confirm that understanding. Because Buddhi may present doubts as to how can it be possible, meaning it is impossible. So from impossibility, one has to land on a possibility. Once one lands on a possibility using tarka, then it will become dridha by punav punav vichara. So punav punav vichara will land you into advaita tattva completely. For that, manana is needed, which is Tarkatmaka. And that Tarkatmaka there also traces back to Shruti. So these are used in the Vasishta Grantha also. And thereby Yoga Vasishta. Yoga Vasishta is a samvada between Sri Rama. Samvada is basically teaching. It's a dialectic where Sri Rama asks questions and Vasishta Muni answers them through stories after stories. So, in fact, there is, you know, those who have seen the movie Inception can't find its basis in Yoga Vasishta because there are multiple levels of stories. You get lost as to which story has led to which one. There is layering after layering. So, in that comparison, the movie Inception would be very basic. Anyway, then itihasa shataischa, lot of itihasa, itihasa has these, you know, ideals that we have who have got the Advaita Moksha. Therefore, that is also used to explain Advaita Tattva, how they understood it. And drishtanta sahasri, thousands of examples are given. In fact, the Yoga Vasishta, which is there, is not complete given. Even the Laghu Yoga Vasishta is quite elaborate. So imagine what would be Yoga Vasishta if it is found in its completeness. Tatra api advaita mata sarabhuta drushti srishti vadaika jiva vadaika satta vadan eva punah punar atyadarena anek itihasaihi samyak pratipadayati cha. So tatra api advaita mata. Advaita mata, but through which methodology, which prakriya it is explained. This sara of Advaita, just like Mandukya is the sara of all Upanishads, and Upanishads are the sara of entire Veda. Similarly, Advaita, which is the sara in Vedanta, Upanishads, the sara of that Advaita is also Drishti Srishti Vada. The difference between Srishti Drishti Vada and Drishti Srishti Vada at a very superficial level is Srishti Drishti Vada says that there is Srishti after which there is Drishti. So Jiva Drishti follows the Srishti which is there. Creation exists and every cognition of each and every Jiva follows the Srishti as the creation is. So nothing is created by the Jiva. Jiva Srishti is still there. Just give me a moment, please. Sorry, I still have cold. So the Srishti is there as created by Ishvara. Whereas Drishti of the Jiva follows that, it does not precede. So, sorry. So, Srishti Drishti Vada means that Ishvara is the Srishti Karta, whereas Jiva uses his five Indriyas and interacts with that Srishti. That is called as Drishti. Each and every Jiva. So it is Aneka Jiva Vada as well. In Drishti Srishti Vada, also there are multiple divisions there, but superficially, it is, in a bird's eye view, it is Drishti which precedes Srishti. Or Drishti itself is Srishti. Meaning the Jiva sees and gives reality to the created. Whatever he sees is created, whether by Ishvara or Jiva, that is debatable, because Jiva is Ishvara Abhinna. In Drishti Srishti Vada, the culmination of the teaching is taken as a fact and then the Srishti is explained. Srishti is not taken as a fact. Srishti is taken as a fact in Srishti Srishti Vada. But in Drishti Srishti Vada, I know that I cognize something, but does it really exist? There the fact is that Ishvara and Jiva are one. So looking at that, the Srishti is as and when there is Drishti. Thereby, another Jiva is also in the Drishti of the Jiva who is a Sadhaka. Whoever is a Sadhaka, he is the Jiva. And when he inquires into what is this Srishti creation outside, that creation is nothing but the vision of the Jiva. This kind of a vision of the Jiva is also there in Srishti Srishti Vada, which is called a Jiva Srishti, which Bhagavan Vidyaranyacharya deals in Panchadashi, 4th chapter. There he says, Ishvara Srishti is there and Jiva Srishti, both are there. Ishvara Srishti is the objective reality. Jiva Srishti is a subjective reality whereby one values something more than the value that it has. That is Jiva Srishti. But in Drishti Srishti Vada, everything is created by a Jiva. And that a Jiva is the Jiva who is Ishvara Abhinna. Therefore, it is Eka Jiva Vada also. There is a possibility of Aneka Jiva Vada in Drishti Srishti Vada also, but not held as logically a better option. It is considered as Eka Jiva Vada is a better option than Aneka Jiva Vada because of the simplicity of Eka Jiva Vada. Calling it Drishti Srishti and using other Jivas is not as useful, might as well stick to Srishti Drishti Vada. Nonetheless, Drishti Srishti Vada, Eka Jiva Vada. This is the commitment of Vasishtha Muni's teaching also. Eka Jiva Vada, further Eka Satta Vada. Eka Satta Vada an eva punah punar atyadairena. Why Atiyadara is there for Drishti Srishti Vada, Eka Jiva Vada and Eka Satta Vada? Eka Satta Vada means that there is only one Satta. Srishti Srishti Vada talks about three Sattas. These three Sattas are to be collapsed into two Sattas. Three Sattas are Paramarthika Satta, Vyavaharika Satta and Pratibhasika Satta. Pratibhasika Satta is Swapnadi. Swapna and, any Kalpana. Bhranti. Whereas Vyavaharika Satta is the objective reality, the waking world. And Paramarthika Satta is the Brahma Satta. In other matas, there are only two Sattas. Paramarthika Satta and Pratibhasika Satta. There is no Vyavaharika Satta. Vyavaharika Satta is there only in Advaita, in the Srishti Drishti Prakriya. Vyavaharika Satta is where there is Vyavahara. But where there is Vyavahara in other matas, that is reality. So the world is as real as Brahma. For them, it is Dvaita. There is Brahma, Ishvara, and there is also Jagat, Jiva. So there is multiplicity. So everything in Vyavahara is considered as Paramarthika Satta. But in Advaita, in Srishti Drishti Vada, there is Vyavaharika Satta also. In Eka Satta Vada, there is only one Satta. How do you land there? Through Mandukya, you collapse the Paramarthika, collapse the Vyavaharika Satta into Pratibhasika Satta. By saying Swapnavat Mithya. Everything in Vyavahara can be analyzed with a simple dream example which everyone has anubhava of, and then any question comes up can be answered by saying Swapnavat. This is like a dream. Oh, there is so much of dukkha. Somebody died. Yes, in the dream if somebody dies, there is equally as much dukkha. The worst example, we have to take the worst example because it is prathamalla nyaya. If the dukkha of the most dear dying can be treated as mithya, then alone, we don't have to say that it is mithya to everyone. But for our understanding, we can take it as mithya. How? Swapnavat mithya. You must have heard of a story where a person does not even cry when his son dies. And his wife is in tears uncontrollably. And she asks, what kind of a father are you? You don't even cry. There is no putra shoka at all. And he says that I do not know how to cry anymore because I have cried. I have shed my tears when I lost 4 of my sons in my dream yesterday night. So he had a dream where he lost 4 of his sons, all of his sons. And he cried for all of them. He cried his heart out. His tears have dried. When he wakes up, this dukkha and this swapna dukkha is still there. It is fresh in his mind. He is unable to decide as to which is real. He understands both are unreal. Therefore, he says that, how can I cry when I already cried for 4? I have no more tears left to cry. I can't cry anymore. Because the dukkha of losing one son versus dukkha of losing 4 sons, just by quantity, if you differentiate, you see that I have had putra shoka multiple times. So, swapnavat mithyatvam is there for vyavaharika satta. It is collapsed into pratibhasika satta. And pratibhasika satta does not have its independent satta because it is always dependent on paramarthika. Therefore, paramarthika satta is the only satta that is eka sattavada. And thereby, satrapi advaita mata sarabhuta drishti srishti vadaika jiva vadaika satta vadan eva punaf punar ati adarena atyadarena aneka itihasaihi samyak pratipadeti cha. Using the itihasa examples also, it has been described. Ittham vyasa valmikyadhyavipraena Upanishad Bhagavad Gita Brahma Sutratmaka Prasthana Tresya Srimad Shankara Bhagavat Pada Pranita Bhashyameva Yathartha Vyakhyanam Iti Siddhyati. So this started with the question, Tattva Drishti, the last one is Tarka Drishti, and this happens to be, here it is, I'm trying to look up.
No, this student is Tarka Buddhi.
Not Tarka Drishti, no. Tarka Drishti is the last one.
Yes, Adrishti.
What is it, sorry? Adrishti.
Adrishti.
Yeah, Adrishti, I'm sorry. Adrishti. Thank you. So Adrishti has asked a question as to, the question was, you have to remember the question. The question is that how is it possible that Veda and Guru, who are both mithya, through their teaching, Adrishte Prashna. What is the Adrishte Prashna? Vedena Gurunacha Advaita Jnanodaya Asambhavaha Iti. It is impossible to get Advaita Jnana and Moksha by teaching of Vedas and Gurus who are themselves mithya. So thereby, Vyasa Valmikyadhyavipraena Upanishad Bhagavad Gita Brahma Sutra, which are all Prasthanatraya Antargata, in all those, what has been discussed is Advaita Mata, that is a Tatparya, as commented upon by Srimad Shankara Bhagavad Pada. So therefore, Srimad Shankara Bhagavad Pada Pranita Bhashyam Eva Yathartha Vyakhyanam. All other vyakhyanas may be there. They may be helpful also, but they are not yathartha vyakhyana. Because there is reinterpretations by adding words to the shrutis even. We have seen examples. Nonetheless, in the opinion of Bhagavan Vyasa, Valmiki, etc. also, Shankara Mata, which is Advaita Mata, which is the commitment of the Shruti and commented upon by Srimad Shankara Bhagavat Pada to bring back the ideas as they are in the Shruti and re-establish them. It is not that he started the Sampradaya. He is not a Sampradaya Krut. He is Sampradaya with. Sampradaya begins with Narayana, Ishvara, Shiva, Dakshinamurti. It is Siddhyati, that is established. Itham Sarvajna Vyasa Valmikyadi Vachana Virodhad Bhedavado Apramanikaha. Thereby anything which is opposed to Advaita, to Abhedavada, being Bhedavada, which is opposed to the Vachanas of Vyasa and Valmiki Ityadi, who themselves are Sarvajna. They are Krantadarshis, they know the future also. So thereby, they have already said that Advaita Mata is Yathartha, Yathartha Bhuta. Thereby, even if those who reinterpret Upanishads in a different manner and claim those to be in keeping with Bhagavan Vyasa's and Bhagavan Valmiki's teaching, they are opposed to their own teachings. They are opposed to their teachings. Thereby, the Bhedavada is apramanikaha. Bhedavado yukti viruddha iti cha Shri Harsha Mishraihi khandana granthe nirupitam. So in khandana khadyam, which is khandana of the Advaita khandana. See, generally, Advaita does mata khandana. And if you look at the others, they do vyakti khandana. They use derogatory means because they don't have any content. If they had content, they would have stuck to it. They would have done the mata khandana is fine. You do Advaita mata khandana, you stick to Dvaita mata or Vishishta Advaita mata, that is fine. So you are a bhakta, very appreciable, continue with Vishnu Bhakti. You do Shiva Khandana also, that is Vyakti Khandana. But let's say that you are not committed to Shiva, we understand, be committed to Narayana, Vishnu, Vayu, whoever. But then you do Vyakti Khandana by calling names to Shankaracharya, that is Asadhu. And they do it every now and then, even now you will find these on YouTube. So their upbringing is such. So we have to see that their upbringing is, they are taught in childhood to do khandana of other gurus, not of the tattva. You do tattva khandana and establish your tattva. This is what Bhagavan Shankaracharya did. He took Shruti as basis and did khandana of the matas because they are all imaginations. They are adding words to the Shruti. They are also tarka viruddha. So tarka yukti virodha has also been shown by other granthas. So bhedavadaha yukti viruddha iti cha Shri Harsha Mishrahi. So Bhagavan Harsha Mishra, who wrote khandana khandana khadya, the grantha is called as khandana khandana khadya. The advaita khandana done by the dvaitins has been done khandana of. So they raise some objections, we counter them and dismantle their philosophy. This is what Bhagavan Vidyaranacharya also does in Panchadashi. Nayayika was a dvaitin. Nayayika comes in, not a dvaita Vedantin, but dvaitin nonetheless. We have seen in the last part that even Bauddhas can be considered as dvaitins. Everyone who is not an Advaiti is a Dvaiti. So, Dvaitins who do Advaita Khandana in Panchadashi, Nayayika comes in the very first chapter itself. Nayayika comes in and asks questions rooted in Tarka. He says, this fails Yukti. Your Advaita Tattva fails Yukti. Then, Bhagavan Vidyaranyacharya took only two verses and dismantled the entire Nyaya Shastra itself. Nyaya Shastra, not Tarka itself, but then their philosophy based on Tarka. Completely dismantled. Only in two verses. So you attack us. It is not that we can't attack. But our defense is, we will dismantle your complete system. This is the method, this is a process used by Advaitins. It is not that we don't know Tarka, but we don't use it. You don't use Shushka Tarka to land on Advaita, but if you do Advaita Khandana through Tarka, being Shruti Viruddha, being Valmikyadi, Vyasa Valmikyadi Viruddha, we'll also show that it is having Yukti Virodha. So, Yukti Viruddhattvam also will show. And thereby, Khandana Khandana Khadya, which refutes the Dvaita Vedantin, who is a Nayayika in the garb of Vedantin, who is not a Vedantin really. Dvaita Vedantin is basically a Nayayika because he uses Tarka, Pradhana. There is no Bhakti which he brings out by showing Bhakti in Vedanta and establishing something. Primarily, his tool to refute others is Tarka. He does not show Shruti Virodha. He shows Tarka Virodha. Therefore, he is a Prachanna Tarkika. Elsewhere, it is said by an Advaitin that they are Dvaita Vedantins. The later, Dvaita Vedanta came much later. So, Dvaita Vedantins are Prachanna Tarkikas. They call Bhagavan Shankaracharya Prachanna Buddha. So, they think that we, as in Bhagavan Shankaracharya, has taken Buddhism and reinterpreted Upanishads, but it is not so, it is the other way around. Buddhists have stolen from Vedas, which is Anadi, from Vedanta, which talks about Advaita, and they have, even refuting every Dvaita, they have negated everything that has to be negated like Advaita does, but they have ended up negating consciousness also, which cannot be negated. The negator of each and every object, that negator has to exist. So they fail the logical test also. They are also Tarkikas. They fail the Tarka. Similarly, Nayayikas fail their own Tarka. And Dvaita Vedantins also fail their Tarka, that is shown in Khandana Khandana Grantha. Yukti Virodha is shown, which is part of Brihat Prasthanatraya. And Bheda Dikkara Adi Granteshu Api, there is Dikkara done. And Dikkara is generally done as a Vitanda Vada. There can be a Samvada, Vada, Samvada. There can be Vitanda Vada also. That's the lowest form of a debate. And what is Vitanda? Vitanda is, it is wrong because you say so. In Vada, there is an establishment of your matha because everyone wants to seek the truth. That is a Samvada also. The second level is where you want to establish your matha by refuting the others. So, Bhashyadi, Tikadis, Granthas are those kind of Granthas. Even Khandana Khandana Khadya is that kind of Grantha, which follows Bhashya style, refutes the others using Tarka, showing Shruti as the basis, and establishes Advaita Tattva. So, the commitment is to establish Advaita Tattva. It is not to find out the truth. The truth has already been found. You have landed on the truth. Now, it is to refute the other pakshas and establish Advaita Tattva, which is the truth. So, Bhagavan Bhashyakara also does the same thing till all the tikas and up till these granthas in Brihat Prasthana, Khandana Khandana Khadya. But Chitsukikara, Bhagavan Chitsukikara, who wrote Chitsuki, that is a pure Vithanda Grantha. Why is it so? Because others use Vithanda, they don't understand anything else. They say that it is wrong just because you say it. It may be Shruti, but since it came through your mouth, it is wrong. This is the ridiculous Vithanda that they do. And the same tool, you know, mostly the same tool has been used in Dhikkara there. So, Bheda Dhikkara Adi Grantheshu, in my understanding, this is talking about Chitsuki. Bheda Dhikkara Adi Grantheshu Api Bheda Vadasya Ayuktatvam Pradarshitam. So, using Yukti, it has been shown, but the commitment is not to establish Advaita at all. It is to show that your objections are wrong, you are wrong. That's all. We don't want to prove Advaita. We want to prove that Dvaita is wrong, which is what every other Purvapakshi does. Dvaita Vedantins and Vishishta Dvaita Vedantins, they say that your Mithya, Maya Vada is wrong. They don't give a solution. They don't give any solution. They just say you are wrong. So, Bheda Dhikkara is that kind of a Grantha where Bheda Vada Khandana has been done. Advaita need not be established. It is already there. Anyway, Ittham Anadi Siddha Shruti Tatparya Vishayi Bhutatvat Smriti Purana Itihasaihi Upabruhitatvat Narayanadi Sadguru Sampradayagatatvacha Shankaram Advaita Matam Iva Sadhu. So Shankaram is Shankaramata. That is sadhu. Why? Because it is anadi siddha shruti tatparya vishayi bhuta. Because it is the vishaya as the tatparya of the shruti, which is anadi siddha. Beginningless shruti. And also followed by smriti, purana, itihasa, all of these. It has been elaborated. Upaprahita can be said as, you know, expounded in Smriti, Purana and Itihasa, the same Advaita Tattva, which began with this entire Sampradaya, began with Narayanadi, who are Sadgurus, ending with Sadguru also. So therefore, Sampradaya Gatatvacha. Everything else has no sampradaya, meaning no continuity. They can call sampradaya, but the lineage is not from Narayana really. It can be claimed. But then you see that every one of these had some Advaita Guru at some point of time. Thereby, they have left the sampradaya. They cannot be called as sampradaya, belonging to sampradaya really. Anyway, but that's a technical point there. Thereby, Shankaram Advaita Matam Yeva Sadhu. Having established this, whatever is taught there has to be the same tattva. Thereby, moksha has to be possible. Sarvaihi Shreyorthivi Adaraniyancha. Those who are looking for the highest Shreya, highest good, this has to be respected. So, Sampradaya and Sampradaya Gata Advaita Tattva should be respected by those who want moksha. This is the first level answer to Adrishti. So, he is indirectly saying that you are not respecting the Tattva as taught by Shruti and Acharyas. So, just by doubting it, you may lose focus of moksha. That's the idea. Then, Bhedavada Tiraskaraha. Advaita Matamandana and Dvaita Matakhandana. So, Abhedavada Mandana and Bhedavada Khandana or Tiraskara. Both have to be done. You cannot have Bheda is also okay and Abheda is also okay. Therefore, Bhedavada Tiraskara has to be done. Jainadi Matavat. Veda Bhaihataya Prachina Maharshi Vajra Virodhacha Bhedavado na Pramanam. Bhedavada is not valid. Why? Because of being opposed to Prachina Maharshi Vachana. The teachings of the earlier rishis who didn't have any confusion or didn't have any other darshana which has popped up, you know, under their own brands. Just like the others who are Veda Bahya. So Veda Bahyatvam is what is the resultant of these newer darshanas also. Although they base themselves on, say that they base themselves on Vedas, they will be just by not following the Prachina Maharshi Vachana, which is in line with Vedamata, just by that reasoning, they are Vedavahya. So that is said here, Jainam, Jainadi Mata Vat. Jainadi Mata is Vedavahya anyway, Bauddhas, etc. But Jainadi Mata Vat, Veda Bahyataya Prachina Maharshi Vachana Virodhacha Bhedavadha Na Pramanam. Because Bhedavada is not in line with Veda by being in line, being opposed to Maharshi Vachana, Prachina Maharshi Vachana. There, that reasoning will take away the claim of being in line with Vedas. Astika Vishaye Bhedavada Khandana Yukti Nam Pradarshanam Napekshitam Mitikritva Sab Bhedavada Shruti Vachana Virudha Ityev Pradarshate. Now Astika Vishaye, the others darshanas who are Astika, meaning they have, they say that Vedas are Pramana, that is Astikya Mata. They can be Nastikas in the sense of not having Ishvara. For example, Purva Mimamsakas and most of the part of Sankhya, they do not have Ishvara. They do not have belief in Ishvara. They don't accept Ishvara. But still they are Astika. So Astika and Nastika, the differentiation is also by generally thought that it is based on whether or not Ishvara is accepted. But the real meaning is Astikya is those who follow Vedas are Astika, those who do not follow Vedas as Pramana, they are Nastikas. So, Astika Vishaye Bhedavada Khandana Yukti Naam Pradarshan Napekshitam. Just Yuktis are not expected, you should not be following. If you are an Astika, then why would you follow Shushka Tarka? What is expected is you show Pramana in Shruti. You say, if Nayayika is asked, why do you say so? He will give you Tarka. He will give you some example and establish some tarka. He will not give you the source in Shruti. Then he will be handpick. If you insist, then he will handpick and give some tangential quotation from Shruti. But primarily, he will take his support from tarka. That should not be the case. It's said here, Astika Vishaye Bhedavada Khandana Yuktina Pradarshanam Napekshitam Iti Krutva. Yuktis are not needed to show Dvaita is not right. Iti krutva sabhedavada shruti vachana viruddha ityeva pradarshate. If you show it is opposed to Shruti, then Astika Mata, be it Nayayika Mata, Puramimamsaka Mata or any other darshana which considers Veda as Pramana, then they have to fall apart. Kata Upanishadi Bheda Vasana Bhaya Hetuhu Sarva Dukkha Nidanam Tataha Sa Vasana Duri Kartavya Iti Mrityuna Nachiketaha Upadishtaha. Nachiketa was taught by Mrityu, Bhagavan Yamaraja. So, Dharmaraja, Yamaraja taught Nachiketa in Kata Upanishad as Bheda Vasana is Bhaya Hetuhu. Bheda leads to Bhaya. And Sarva Dukkha Nidanam. Nidanam is Karanam. It's also the source for, cause for all sorts of Dukkhas. Tataha Sa Vasana. Which Vasana? Bheda Vasana. Duri Kartavya. You should set aside the Bheda Vasana. You should not consider duality as a fact. You should not be committed to duality. You should transgress the plurality, duality. Iti Mrityuna Nachiketa Upadishtaha. Nachiketa was taught by Mrityu. Nachiketa is Prathama Ekvachana of Nachiketas. It is a Sakaranta Pullinga Shabda. Tasmad Bhedavasana Sarvatmana Manasu Nirmulam Nirmulam Unmathaniya. So Unmathaniya. What should be done therefore? It should be uprooted. Bhedavasana should be uprooted by Sarvatma Bhava. Sarvatmana Sarvatmana manasaha nirmulam unmathaniya. It should be uprooted in such a manner that they not even the roots remain. That is uprooting. So when you uproot, if some part of the roots are broken, they'll again become a sapling and then grow up to a plant or a tree. Therefore, the Bhedavasana should be completely uprooted. Satatam Advaita Nishta Abhyasaniya Shreyavarthina. Therefore, one who is Shreyavarthi. Shreyavarthi is Mumukshu. Mokshaarthi. That Sadhaka should commit to Advaita Mata continuously. And repeat that. Abhyasaniya, tatahi shrutaya, and such shrutis are there. Mrityo samrityam apnoti, ya ihanane vapashyati, dityad vaibhayam bhavati, anyosa anyos hamasmiti, nasaveda yatha, pashurevam sa devana, udaramantaram kurute, atatasya bhayam bhavati, tasam chayamartha. All these shrutis have one meaning. Which shrutis? Kata Upanishad says, Mrityosa Mrityum Apnoti Ya Iha Nanya Iva Pashyati. Yaha Nana Iva Iha Yaha Nana Iva Pashyati. As though there is duality, one who sees that, sees or cognizes. One who interacts as though there is an object other than the subject, giving Dvaita reality. Why giving a reality? Why is it not real? Because of the Iva Shabda here. Nana Iva. Plurality cannot be real. Then if it is real, then there cannot be Iva. Iva means it is as though Nana. As though plural. It is not plural. But if one takes the plurality as real, then what will happen? We'll continue in samsara. That person continues in samsara. Saha mrityoho mrityum apnoti. We'll go from death to death. How can one go from death to death? Only if one is born again. So, samsarati tyartha. Dvitiyad vai bhayam bhavati says, Brihad Upanishad. So, dvitiyad hetoho vai indeed there is bhaya. Anyaha asau, anyaha aham asmi. One who says that I am different from Paramatma, asau Paramatma. From that Paramatma, I am different. Anyaha asau Paramatma, anyaha aham jivaha, or anyaha asau jivaha, anyaha aham jivaha, anyat tat jagat, anyaha aham, or any kind of plurality. So duality, we have seen Bhedas are at all levels. And at all levels, they are mithya. Iti nasa veda. He does not know anything. He does not know the reality. He knows mithya. So that is not real knowledge. Nasa veda yatha. And what will be his lot? His course will be being a pashu, as though a pashu. Pashuhu eva sadevanam. Pashur eva sadevanam. So in fact, Brihadaranyaka Upanishad does ninda. Nahi nindyanaya is used there. He is as though like a pashu. Because devas, for devas, as though he is domesticated by the deities who want the manushyas to keep on serving them. Nothing wrong in that. But it is seen from the highest level, it is seen that the person is doing dharmakarya, all right. But dharmakarya will give you swarga and you will continue in samsara. You should use dharma for chitta shuddhi, not for laukika phala. So, if one uses the deva karya is being done for laukika phala iha amutra, whether here or hereafter. I want swarga, I want pitruloka, I want brahmaloka, then also, or in laukika, I want wealth here, I want putra, pashu, dhana, all these, whatever idea is there, whether here or hereafter, that will make the person continue in samsara to do the same things again and again. Therefore, as though domesticated pashu for devas, that kind of a person serves the goal of deities, who are also jivas. Devas are also jivas. They are manifested entities of one aspect of Ishvara. Just like a jiva is one ansha. In jiva bhava, there is anshatvam. Udaramantaram kurute, one who does even a little difference. Athatasya bhayam bhavati, there will be bhaya, the same Brahma is the source of bhaya as well as abhaya. Abhaya for a jnani, for a mumukshu, and then a jnani. Bhaya hetu, Ishvara is also bhaya hetu for a papi, or even one who wants to do punya, but then fails. For a laukika person, tasam chayam artha, what is the meaning there? Ya iha paramatmani pratyag abhinne, that paramatma who is non-different from pratyagatma, the innermost self, trivida paricheda, trivida bheda shunye, nana iva, iva shabdad avidyamanam eva bhedam pashyati. So iva shows that the bheda is not there, but he still sees bheda. That bheda which is non-existent is seen by this person. Therefore, yaha pashyati bheda shunye paramatmani pratyagavinne paramatmani. In that paramatma, he is seeing bheda. That bheda is not anywhere else. It is in the same paramatma who is your own swarupa. In that kind of you are seeing a difference. Bheda, where bheda is not there. Bheda shunye atmani paramatmani brahmatmani pratyagavinne brahmatmani trivida paricheda trivida bheda shunye. There is no difference at all. Trivida, or earlier shown as Panchavida. Five types of Bhedas have been shown. Or here Trivida Bheda is the Bheda which is Swagata. Those kind of Swagata Adi Bheda. And Trivida Paricheda Shunya is Desha Kala Vastu Paricheda Shunya. Atma Paramatma which is bereft of three types of differences, three types of limitations. In that kind of Brahmatma, one sees Nana Iva. Saha Mritva Mritva Punav Punar Jayate. He is going to be born again and again by dying again and again. Dvaita Bhinna, sorry. Dvaitabhinivishtasya sadabhayam eva chinmatra swaswarupat prithak neyatvena dhyayatvena va vastvantaram asti iti manvana pashuprayaha. And what is the meaning of this pashureva sadevanam? So that is explained pashuprayaha, comparable to pashu. Why? Because he considers a separate vastu neyatvena dhyayatvena va. Whether he knows that vastu, or even we can say imagines, meditates upon that kind of a vastu which is different from him. So he can be a great yogi also, but if he is having bheda drishti, he is doing paramatma dhyana, but still paramatma is separate from himself, then pashuprayaha. That is the meaning of the Brihad Upanishad mantra there. Dvaitabhinivishtasya sadabhayam eva, always one who is actually continuing in dvaita, inquires and lands into dvaita, for him sadabhayam eva chinmatra swaswarupat prithak niyatvena, because he sees everything as separate from himself, which is the chinmatra swarupa. Therefore, there is bhaya. अणुमात्रम अपि भेदं पश्यतो महद्भयं भवति. सो उदरमंत्रम कुरुते तैत्रीय मंत्र इज एक्सप्लेन्ड हियर. अणुमात्रम अपि भेदं पश्यतो, वन हु सीज इवन अ लिटिल डिफरेंस. नो लेट मी हैव ओनली दिस डिफरेंस, यू नो एवरीथिंग एल्स इज ओके बट आई कैन नॉट बी परमात्मा. ओके आई एम लाइक अदर जीवास, देयर इज नो डिफरेंस बिटवीन अस, बट परमात्मा, कम ऑन परमात्मा आई कैन नॉट बी. सो इवन इफ वन डज अ लिटिल भेद देन महद्भयं भवति. दुःख निदान भूतो भेदवादः श्रेयोर्थिना सर्वता विस्मर्तव्यः. वन शुड कंप्लीट दिस भेदवाद, यू नो कंप्लीटली फॉरगेट इट. वन शुड नॉट इवन रिकॉल भेद इवन इन व्यवहार. इन व्यवहार अद्वैत दृष्टि शुड कंटिन्यू. दैट इज द आइडिया देयर. द्वैत वचनम यावद् अनुस्मर्यते तावद् अद्वैत साक्षात्कार नोदीयात् इति अदृष्टि नामकं शिष्यं गुरु उपदिदेश. सो गुरु उपदिदेश, गुरु टॉट द शिष्य हु इज कॉल्ड एज अदृष्टि, दैट एज लॉन्ग एज यू हैव द्वैत वचन, द्वैत वचन यावत् अनुस्मर्यते, एज लॉन्ग एज यू इवन रिमेंबर द द्वैत मत, द्वैत वचन, इवन इफ यू थिंक दैट देयर इज अनदर इन नाम रूप ऑल्सो, देन तावद् अद्वैत साक्षात्कार न उदिया, देर विल बी नो साक्षात्कार बॉर्न. मीनिंग देर विल बी नो अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ अद्वैत विच विल स्टे. इवन इफ यू अंडरस्टैंड इट, इट विल बी लॉस्ट ऑन यू इफ यू होल्ड ऑन टू द्वैत. दैट इज वाई संन्यास, द पर्सन हू हैज अद्वैत दृष्टि रियली हैज नो अधिकार इन कर्म, बिकॉज कारक भेद इज लॉस्ट. कारक भेद नॉट बीइंग देयर यू कैनॉट बिकम अ कर्ता. कर्तृत्व भोक्तृत्व नॉट बीइंग पॉसिबल इवन. नो कारका इज अवेलेबल, नो कर्ण कारका, नो अधिकरण इज अवेलेबल. देर इज नो अग्नि अवेलेबल फॉर यू टू डू होम. वेर इज द कर्माधिकार? सो कर्म अधिकार इज नॉट देर. फर्स्ट यू बिकम एन अधिकारी बाय टेकिंग यज्ञोपवीत, डू द कर्म, गेट चित्त शुद्धि, अंडरस्टैंड द वेदांत तत्व, and thereby drop your adhikaritvam. So the goal is to go from anadhikari to adhikari, through adhikaritvam land with chitta shuddhi and advaita jnana and lose the adhikara and become anadhikari again. So you end up where you started but with jnana. So thereby the dvaita vachana smriti also is lost on a jnani really. So that is the 229th avarta. We'll stop here and continue in the next part. So now there is a bharchu katha. So this is what I was saying, that I'll spend little time here. I'll treat the stories and, you know, some of the quotations as just quotations. We'll look at the bhavartha. And I have also skipped the I'll just read through these before maybe tomorrow I'll read through this. It is just establishing the, it just shows the quotations, giving quotations from Ramayana, Uttara Ramayana as to CET. These are the quotations which land on Advaita Tattva. So these are given by the Tippanakara. सुखं नित्यं सप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृक्यत्वं अपारं सर्व वेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्येक परम तदेव अहन्नमत्वन्यत् इति मे निश्चिता मतिः. एनी क्वेश्चंस? कैन सी इन द नेक्स्ट पार्ट. नमस्ते.
नमस्ते.
हरिओम.